In this platinum resistance thermometer experiment, we are going to study variation of resistance of a platinum wire at different temperatures, and we are going to calculate the temperature coefficient of the platinum wire. Basically, the resistance of the platinum wire is very very small, and it is very difficult to calculate the resistance of platinum wire accurately. So in this experiment, we are going to perform a very, you can say, careful experiment. And we are going to use Carey-Forster bridge decay resistance box to calculate the you can say small change in the resistance. So this is the circuit diagram of this platinum resistance thermometer. Here two known resistance boxes are connected. So R1 and R2 are variable resistance boxes. So the P is the platinum wire that we are going to connect, and C is the compensating wire that we will connect, and S is the Carey-Forster bridge resistance. And we are also going to supply some small amount of voltage in this bridge, and G is the ammeter, which will see the deflection in the you can say we need to nullify this deflection. So we have given this formula. So where alpha is equal to resistance at boiling point of water minus resistance at room temperature divided by R0 in bracket 1, so temperature, boiling point temperature minus resistance at 0. So basically this is a well known formula. We know that, let's say, R2, which is equal to R1 1 plus alpha T2 minus T1, where this R2 is the resistance at temperature T2. So this is resistance at temperature T2. R1 is the resistance at temperature T1, and T2 is the temperature, higher temperature, and T1 is the lower temperature. Alpha is the temperature coefficient. So whenever we have this formula, we can rearrange this formula to find out the value of alpha. So we have R2 which is equal to R1 plus R1 into alpha T2 minus T1. So in order to find R1 alpha T2 minus T1, this will be R2 minus R1. Now this alpha is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into T2 minus T1. So basically, if we know resistance at higher temperature, resistance at some lower temperature, and higher temperature and lower temperature in degree Kelvin, then we can find the temperature coefficient of this resistance. So same thing we are going to do. Higher temperature we are going to use. This is the boiling point of water, and this is the room temperature of the water. So this is the resistance at room temperature of water, and this is the resistance at the boiling point of the water that we are going to use. So initially what we are going to do, so there is a small wire, okay, and we are going to use this wire for finding the you can say null point. And there are P is the platinum wire that is connected. These R1 and R2 are variable resistances. We are going to keep these resistances as 2 ohms, and this C is the compensating wire, and S is the decayed resistance box. So in order to find the null point, we are going to move the this point along this wire. Let's say this is point let's say A and B. So along AB we are going to move our pointer so that we get a null point. So initially we will keep these resistances means 2 ohm 2 ohm, and this we have to change this S resistance. This C resistance and P resistance is, means the resistance of the platinum wire and resistance of the compensating wire is constant. We have to change the resistance of this S and make it 0. So here all these things are given. So we have to find null points at 3 different places. Let's say here at 24 centimeters, here let's say at 25 centimeter, and let's say at 26 centimeter. So this is 50 centimeter wire. AB distance is 50 centimeter, so we have to 50 minus the distance. Let's say it is 24, so 50 minus 24, that is 26 into rho is the resistivity of that wire. So resistivity multiplied by distance, that gives us a resistance of that wire. That resistance is added into the resistance of the decade counter S1, and this is at, let's say, let's say this is RT1. Similarly, we are going to calculate the RT2 and RT3, and we are going to take average of these three resistances at room temperature. And we know the resistance of the wire. So rho is the resistivity of the wire. So it is not a resistance, it is resistivity. So it is 0.0346 ohm per centimeter. This is the resistivity of that wire. And so it is resistivity. RT is the resistance at room temperature. So initially this was defined for the, let's say, initially it was this formula was defined for the finding the resistance at room temperature as RT. So there was a formula like RT is equal to R0 1 plus alpha T2 minus T1. This was also formula which was used. So at that time RT is the room temperature resistance, R0 is the resistance at the 0 degree Celsius. Now we are going to use, you can say, similar formula, and we are going to get the temperature coefficient. So in this experiment, first we are going to do the connections as shown. So connect the circuit as shown. We have to connect the circuit, measure the resistance of the wire connected between the points 5 and 6 using the good multimeter. So between these two wires, so we had a wire between A, point A and B. So we have to measure the resistance between A and B and divide the divided by that length, and we will get that resistivity. So resistivity we will get. So if we know the you can say resistance is directly proportional to length, inversely proportional to area of cross section, and it is proportionality constant is rho. So if we want to find the rho, we have to find the resistance between the points, area of cross section, and then finally we have to find the length of that wire. So if we do so, we will find the resistivity of that wire. Take the values of R1 and R2 resistances to be, R1 and R2 should be same, and we should be equal to 2 ohm. We are going to take it 2 ohm, so it should be technically less than 4 ohm, and keep the resistance box S1 equal to the resistance of the platinum wire. In this case, null point is near about 25 centimeter. So in decade counter, I will show this decade counter picture at the end. So we can change the resistances by very small amount, like 1 ohm, 2 ohm, or 0.1 ohm, or let's say 0.01 ohm. So we can change that small amount of resistances, and we will get that resistance. Then increase the S indicated resistance so that we get null point, so around 26 centimeter. Decrease S so that null point is approximately 224 centimeter. So we can do these changes and calculate the mean resistances. So it is R1, so RT1, RT2, RT3, its mean is taken, and it is denoted by R or RT. And repeat this procedure at 0 degree Celsius. It should be 0 degree Celsius and 100 degree Celsius. So 0 degree Celsius, we are going to take it as you can say room temperature. So in our case, we are going to, let's say, do these things at room temperature. And this, even if we say that water boils at 100 degree Celsius, this is true at seashore. And we are going to take it in our laboratory, where the water boils it around 98 or 99 degree Celsius. So this is your T2, and calculate the mean value of R0, R0 and RBP, and we have this formula. So formula is already discussed. So connect the circuit as shown, adjust the values of S, okay, then calculate the values of resistance of a platinum wire by formula. We can calculate it and heat the water. We have to do the same procedure at, we have to find the resistances at three different distances at boiling point of the water. And so find the values of S and get the null point at the center of the wire while cooling the, at you can say 10 degrees Celsius differences. So we can see, we will get a table which is something like this. So at around 98 degrees Celsius, water boils because the air pressure is a little bit smaller in our area. And then so with a small decrease in the temperature, we can keep on getting the, you can say, different values of x. So we will get values of s, and here we will get the value of x, and we can calculate the value of r. So we can do it up to room temperature, and we will get this table. Then we can plot this graph of you can say resistance versus temperature, and we can also calculate the alpha. So alpha is basically 1 upon r0 r2 minus r1 upon t2 minus t1. So here, where we can directly get this slope 1 upon r0 into, you can say, this is dr upon dt. So we will get a slope by using that graph, and we can calculate the alpha. So where r0 is the resistance at 0 degree Celsius, you can say by interpolation it is given, but we can also you can say take the, we can say by using that graph, we can find the value of r0, and average value of dr upon dt is taken, and which is a slope in our figure. So this dt should be capital D because it is temperature. So most of the time small t is shown for the time, and capital T is given for the temperature. So by this way we can find out the temperature coefficient. So this temperature coefficient plays very important role. So this is your decayed resistance. If you see this decayed resistance carefully, you can see x1. So here it is shown 0, then it is 1, then it is 2, like this way it is, let's say, up to 10. Okay, so it is 0 ohm, 1 ohm, 2 ohm, like this way. If we rotate it, we can change the resistances, and this is knob is we can say indicator is here. So it is 0 ohm. If we change it to 1, it will be 1 ohm. Like this way we can change the resistances. In the second case, we can change the resistances like 0.1 into 1, let's say 0.1 into 2, like this way 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, up to 10 into 0.1. So this much change can be done by second knob. Similarly, third knob, by using this third knob, we can change the resistance by 0.00. So if this is, let's say, first knob, it gives 1 ohm, 2 ohm change. Second knob gives change of 0.1 ohm. Third knob gives change of 0.0 ohm. This fourth knob gives a change. Okay, so it is by you can say one interval is 100 into 1, and this one is 100. So one knob gives 10 ohm. So like this way we can rotate the knobs by using this, let's say, these three knobs. Typical value which we need to take in our experiment is around 3. So you should not keep on rotating these knobs because this is very delicate instrument. So you make sure you rotate it properly. So this is this, you can say, galvanometer is used for the looking for the zero direction. Then we are going to use 2 ohm resistance. So here we have, we can unpin this two pins, and we can get the 2 ohm resistances, and this is the pin which we are going to rotate over this slate. And there is small wire, if you can see, there is this small wire is there, okay, around this, which is connecting these points. Okay, so this is actual experimental stuff. And in this figure you can see there are, you can say, white beads are there. So platinum wire is there, and it is protected by white beads. Okay, these are alumina beads. These are alumina beads, okay, and in between these alumina beads there is platinum wire, so which is in yellow color. Okay, and this green color wire is kept for the, means green color wire is connected to the compensating, and this is for platinum wire. And in this you can say container, we can heat that water. We can put the water by using burner. We can heat it, and finally we can at room temperature, and at 100 degrees Celsius, means around 100 degrees Celsius temperature, we can measure the resistances. So this is the actual connections that I have done. So here this is the power supply. Okay, so this is used to provide the voltage. These are the two resistance boxes. Let's say R1 variable resistance, R2 variable resistance. This is your galvanometer. There, this is your wire. So this is your wire along this line, and here connections are made. So these are the, you can say, this is your decade counter on right hand side, and here it is a platinum wire is connected. Okay, so you can do this connection by using your figure, and make sure whenever you do such connections, you check it from your teacher and then you proceed.